Kreutzer motif. A motif is just like a short phrase. It's just like an idea, a melodic idea. So the motif, it's also known as a character in a book. If you're writing a book or a novel, or if you're reading a novel, they have motifs or characters. For music, we think of a character as a motif. So these motifs show up, and the Kreutzer motif that I'm going to use is this. So there are certain, I'm going to try to make this as much of a performance as I can. So there are certain things you can do with the motif. First of all, you can do something called transposing the motif, which is just when you move it to a different place. So you can put it here. Transposing the motif. Moving it around. You can also invert the motif. So that would be like the mirror image of the motif. It'd be like playing it backwards, kind of. Actually, no, that's something else. But let me see. How do you do that? I could invert and transpose the motif. Expand the motif, like play it really slow. And I could play it really fast.
Right.
And there's all kinds of other things you can do with it. I probably won't do any of those things. When I think of improvisation, sometimes I'll do it in a really, really constrained, like really specific way, but other times I'll just do it in a broad way. And I think that the goal should be to be able to be free when you improvise. And to be able to, sometimes when you improvise and you're creative, you just do it to see what happens. Other times you put it under the microscope and you judge it and you criticize it or you go for a certain thing. But in this case, I'm going